50 Cent Bulletproof. Is the game really that bad? Or has the game really got a lot going for it? That's what we're gonna find out today in this review of 50 Cent Bulletproof. I'm Nick, welcome and enjoy. Now, let's start from scratch. It was developed by Genuine Games, a studio in the Valley of LA, known for making Fight Club, which wasn't really a success. It was time for Genuine Games to make a big comeback, and that was 50 Cent Bulletproof. Before we get in depth about the development and the video game, how did this game even came about? Gangster music was very popular in the 2000s and was also brought back in video games such as GTA, Def Jam Fight Club, Scarface, and True Crime. And that's where Sean Krenkel comes in. Sean Krenkel was working at Vivendi Universal and apparently pitched the idea to Jimmy Iovine at 50 Cent's PIMP music video. Also very important, the game's story was written by Terrence Winter, who also worked on the movie Get Rich or Die Trying and also working on The Sopranos. There was also top-notch voice acting from people such as John DiMaggio, Nolan North, Chad Coleman, 50 Cent, Dr. Dre, Eminem, and of course G-Unit. The game was built from the ground up in what seems to be Autodesk Maya in about 12 to 14 months, which is very impressive looking at all the models, dialogue and story that was put together. Looking at the combat and the not so good aim mechanic, it was sometimes really a pain completing the game at all. If you were looking for a relaxed shooter, you picked up the wrong game. Even Sean Krenkel says the game was bad, but was it really all that bad? The game has a lot going for it. Every single cutscene was done to perfection. For its time, the game got praised for the good animations, not even to begin with the fact they made a whole story around 50 Cent getting shot 9 times. It was clear the developers and the whole team behind this game was dedicated to make it work, and apart from the wonky combat and the bad aiming, it did work. 50 Cent, Dr. Dre and Eminem had a very good dialogue, not bad at all, like some other games. All the cutscenes with Eminem are very funny. You can't help but bond with the characters you interact with, especially this guy, Bugs.
Shit, look at him rolling with this old school type phone.
I'm looking to pull his messages. Think you can break his code?
I can't. But this here can. Invented it myself. It's gonna cost you though.
Critics put this game in the cash grab section, but if you ask me, this doesn't feel like one. You can clearly see this was made with passion from the developers and the actors. Since this is a game based all around 50 Cent, the music is also from 50 Cent. Add in some of the G-Unit characters, add some of the amazing G-Unit music, and you're ready to go. You can even call your friends and hear their voicemails, and they're funny as shit.
Hey yo, what up, man? It's your boy Banks, man. I'm out taking care of business. If it's important, leave a message. Hey yo, what up, man? It's your man, Young Buck, man. Right now, I'm busy. I'm in the kitchen doing my thug thizzle. So y'all holler back.
I'm out pumping bitches. Leave a message.
I'm probably fixing up some anima. Not here right now.
Hey, right now, I'm AWOL. But you know the drill.
Hi, this is Detective McVicker. I'm not here right now.
Beep.
I'm out right now. Phone later.
Yeah, it's the talk of New York, and right now I'm either fucking your bitch, getting some money, or doing something better to do with my time, but I'm tied up. Leave it.
50 Cent is the playable character. And the others, well, let's hear 50 say it.
Lloyd Banks, he's a legend. The only thing he can't break into is his own stash. Tight with his money, but loose with other people. This is Young Buck. This nigga got crazy weapon skills. He had my back since preschool. If it's got a caliber, he used it.
Let's go. We moving out.
This is Yayo. Toe to toe, he'll fuck niggas up. He fast as shit too.
The hub is actually really well put together giving that open world feeling. You can enter 50's apartment, buy music from DJ Who Kid at his car, or talk to Eminem, buy guns in the alley with Dr. Dre, learn new combat skills in the theater, and buy meds from Doc Friday. Now, let's take a deep dive into the story, because that's amazing. The game starts with his friend K-Dog calling 50 Cent asking for help. Because 50 is a good friend, he picks up his weapon, calls G-Unit, and heads towards K-Dog. After seeing the first cutscene, you learn that K-Dog is indeed in trouble, so you start killing the militia to get to K-Dog. After being too late looking for K-Dog, you see 50 Cent getting shot 9 times.
Motherfuckers had some real ass firepower, but whoever they were, this wasn't the time to stick around and find out.
Then 50 wakes up seeing Doc Friday, a hood doctor that lost his license because he was giving himself prescriptions. After taking his meds, we see 50 tripping out before falling asleep. Or as Doc Friday says,
"You're back to sleep. Just close your eyes. Think of pussy."
Truth is, there isn't much else I could do. And the happiest thought I could think was finding the motherfucker who bent me up.
When 50 wakes up, he walks around his hood, meeting his friends, and trying to find out why he got shot 9 times. We got Bog that runs the pawn shop, losing his legs after falling down from an elevator shaft. He looted your place so he can sell your stuff because he thought you were dead.
"What the fuck? That's my stereo. And my plasma too. What's all this doing here?"
"You were shot 9 times, dawg. How'd I know you was gonna live?"
"Man, get this shit delivered back to my crib."
"Hey, sorry, man."
Later through the game, Bugs gives you tips and helps you progress through an airpiece. Then you meet Chris, which is Dr. Dre, an ex-war veteran who sells guns out of his van to make some extra money. He also gives you a collector's mission to collect phones for money.
"What the fuck? Oh shit, is that a ghost?"
Then we got Popcorn, a crazy addict that lives in an abandoned theater.
"Reality for good.
Ha! Say hello to my little friend!"
That teaches you extra combat skills for some money. He only talks in movie quotes, which is very funny. Then we meet Detective McVigor, which is Eminem, a corrupt cop you can get information from in exchange for money. And I have to mention, all his scenes are funny.
"Well, look who it is. For a while there, I thought I lost my best customer.
It'll take more than 9 bullets to bring me down."
"Yeah, thanks, I'll remember that."
From McFigger, we learn that K-Dog is staying in a big mansion up in Scarsdale, under FBI protection. So 50 and Lloyd Banks head up to the mansion to see what's going on. Upon arrival, 50 finds out K-Dog is dead alongside the FBI agents, probably killed by the same militia that you killed during the prologue. After taking a closer look at K-Dog, 50 Cent sees a tattoo he doesn't recognize. He also finds his phone and takes it back to Bugs to see if he can do anything with it. Fifty hears from McVigor that he's now the main suspect for killing K-Dog and the FBI agents after a setup. Fifty learns from a device Bugs made that he was supposed to meet Spider, a crystal meth dealer, at a junkyard. So that's the next objective.
"K-Dog, where you been? You were supposed to meet Spider with the transpo routes 3 days ago."
"So you're the famous K-Dog."
"That's right."
"Spider tells me you're late."
"Sorry, man. Things got fucked up."
"You're not following me. When he said late, he meant it like the late K-Dog. Never seen a dead dude walking before."
50 heads towards the junkyard, pretending to be K-Dog. The bikers are not falling for it. A shootout happens. Spider isn't happy to meet 50 either. After fighting Spider, you see he has the same tattoo as K-Dog on his arm. Spider tries to escape the meth lab, but that doesn't work after he bleeds out. 50 sees the opportunity to take the tattoo, so he cuts it out of his arm. I don't know why he didn't take a picture, but okay. He heads back to Bugs to show the tattoo. After some thinking, they know a creepy guy with an eye patch called Wu-Jang that has the same tattoo.
"Damn, 50, this how you gonna wake a nigga up? What, you couldn't take a picture?"
Before going to Chinatown, 50 goes to Booker, a local homeless man that sees and hears everything.
Hey there. Good morning.
Hey, listen. There may be some people coming around here looking for me, okay?
What kind of people?
Government people in suits.
50 heads towards Chinatown, kills all of them, and steals their money while doing it.
Shit, it's fucking payday.
50 heads home taking the subway, only finding out the militia group is waiting for 50 Cent, destroying the train. 50 is fighting the same militia in the subway tunnels, trying to escape, until we kill the leader at the end. We find out it's not a random militia group, but it's a DEA doing it, making it even harder to find out what's going on.
A very big one. Oh, fuck. Gabriel Spinoza, Special Agent, Drug Enforcement Agency.
The day after, he takes a day off by staying in bed and getting a kiss from Eminem. Mwah. 50 asks McVigor for information about the DEA agent, but McVigor is ready to collect his debt. He has to take out an ex-cop named Petra, who discovered McVigor is a dirty cop. He has to take him out before he snitches on McVigor. 50 and Yayo head to the projects where Petra is located and just do that.
That's where I came in.
Yo, you niggas lost?
Nah, we right here where we wanna be.
You sure about that?
I am if Petra's here.
You need to get the fuck out of here, B.
Guess there's nothing else for us to talk about.
Now, before I continue, this game has a lot of cut content. I also have a different version of the audio you just watched, which I'll be showing at the end of the video, so make sure you stick around. They rush back to their hood to get more information about the corrupt DEA agent from the subway. 50 then learns that K-Dog was involved in some kind of drug conspiracy ring, and learns about a waterfront warehouse that is shipping drugs to Colombia, Turkey, and Afghanistan.
You looking for trouble?
I'm looking for information.
Yeah, well, information ain't free.
50 heads to the dockyard to get more information, and they're not happy that he's sniffing around. They shut the doors, and 50 has to escape. But of course, not without his shipping schedules.
Call me cynical, but when a dude goes from treating me like shit to offering me coffee in 30 seconds, I'd say that dude set me up. After all that work, there was no way I was leaving without getting what I came for.
Heading back to Queens, he can't wait to show Booker that he got it while walking up to him. A drive-by starts and Booker gets killed in the process.
Booker. Oh no, Booker.
At the funeral of Booker, 50 meets his daughter, Alexa, and she has a ton of new information about all of this. Turns out, Booker was an undercover CIA agent, trying to uncover the whole drug operation that K-Dog and also 50 Cent got wrapped up in. 50 then meets up with McVigor and finds out that the leader of the DEA is Spinoza. He pulls all the strings and is the one that shot 59 times. He also gets a tip to talk to Eduardo Vasquez. McVigor mentions he won't be so talkative, but forgot to mention he was a drug mule that died of a bag of drugs that burst in his stomach. But the bag wasn't heroin, like the MI thought, it was opium. Not your usual type of street drug. McVigor tells 50 of a recent arrest of a wise guy in Little Italy, but they wasn't informed on the case, so they had to let him go. 50 then heads to the city morgue, trying to figure out what the hell happened to Eduardo Vasquez.
Yep, county morgue, you kill him, we chill him. Sorry, ma'am, I thought you were a buddy of mine.
50 then puts Eduardo Vasquez into the oven, and that's the end of the morgue. After finishing up in the city morgue, 50 heads to Little Italy to fight with the mafia. It doesn't end well and got knocked out. Now, normally I wouldn't show a whole cutscene, but this one is so crazy you have to see this. Check this out.
Come on, let's find Capitolupo.
You just did, asshole.
I woke up after what seemed like hours. When I saw what happened, I almost wish I didn't wake up at all. Oh, fuck.
Good, you're awake. Wouldn't want you to miss all the fun.
Capitolupo, you sick motherfucker.
It's not me who's the sick one. It's my pally, Sam the Butcher. Go on, Sam. Show him what happens to people who don't mind their own business.
You don't have to be like this, man. Come on, man. You don't have to be like this.
Come on, man. He's just a kid.
As far as I'm concerned, he's just a piece of meat. I gotta say, kid, I admire your ambition. But the truth is, you ain't gonna do shit. Start with his legs. Cut this big shot down to size.
What's this shit? Yo, 50, let's go!
Looks like I got here just in time, man.
I'm glad you here. How'd you find me, man?
Shit, Bugs hit me up, man. He's been watching.
They kill the mob boss and find out the boss was the informant himself.
Looks like Nivigo was right. There was an informant in Capitol Lupo's crew.
Shit, Capitol Lupo himself.
Guess you can't even trust the boss these days.
They find his recording tapes, head to Bugs, plays it, and they hear the mob boss and Spinoza talking. But the third person, they didn't know who that was. His name is Maktara Muhammad, smuggling all the drugs, but also being a terrorist, bringing opium, explosives, and guns into New York. After discovering all of this, Spinoza and Muhammad capture Alexo to get leverage so 50 would let him do his thing. In the meantime, McVigor arrests 50 Cent so he can get all the glory. 50 is put into jail, but not for long. Booker comes in, 50 freaks out, thinking he was dead.
Let's go. You're out.
Holy shit, you're alive.
It would certainly appear that way, wouldn't it?
But how?
We're talking a car. Let's go.
50 Cent and G-Unit head to the dock, killing Muhammad and quickly searching for Spinoza. When finding Spinoza, 50 sees Spinoza, Alexa and McVigor in one room. Eminem gets shot in the knee and Spinoza runs off. 50 runs after him and the final boss happens. But the final boss fight was so simple, it could have been any random enemy. Let me show you a clip. Fifty then shoots more bullets into him, making sure he's dead. Something that Spinoza forgot in the prologue.
One thing they didn't teach you in the DEA: when you go to kill someone, make sure they're fucking dead.
50 and G-Unit walks off while the SWAT team enters the dock. Booker thanks us all for the help, walks off, and Alexa smacks 50's ass. Then the game finishes with some final words to McVigor.
How you feeling?
I've been shot. What do you think?
I think I got a pretty good idea how that feels.
It was just business, 50. Nothing personal.
You take care of yourself, McVigor.
What's this for?
I don't know. Spend it on your kid.
Tell you the truth, I don't even have a kid.
To tell you the truth, that gives me some hope for humanity.
Since this game was made for 50, the music is top notch. All of his songs are included up until release. I'm personally a big fan, so I loved it instantly. He also made an album for the game, which I can't play because of copyright. But it's still great even for today's standard. It's called Bulletproof. You should check it out. Another big flaw besides the controls is, for example, when your crew is helping you. So G-Unit helps you while playing, but sometimes when Lloyd Banks has to open a door, it just takes forever. He gets stuck on a wall, or he gets hit and he just stops doing it, or for whatever reason he just doesn't want to walk through the door. That takes just forever. The AI is bad. And the square button has multiple functions: executing, reloading, taking cover, and stealing. Sometimes you want to execute an enemy, but there's a dead one on the floor in front of you. So instead of executing him, you're going to try and steal the money from the dead person that's on the floor, which can result in you dying. And that's just so annoying. Does the general public like this game? I think no. Basically because most people buy a game just to play and relax on the couch, while this game has such bad control scheme, it can make it really hard to enjoy your free time. They did make a PSP version later on that people loved more and was more playable. I really don't get why people hate it so much. The game has way more good things to offer than bad. And especially for its era, I mean, most PS2 game had a bad control scheme. So it's not only Bulletproof. So after all the hate, you'd say the game flopped, right? Well, if we have to believe Sean Krenkel, the game sold over 5 million units combined with the PSP version, which is really a lot for a PS2 game. Because of the good sales from 50 Cent Bulletproof, we also later on in 2009 We got 50 Cent Blood on the Sand. It had way better reviews, but it sold very bad, which also was the last game 50 Cent produced, sadly. Overall, I'd give this game a 9 out of 10 for story, a 10 out of 10 for music, because you know, 50 fan here, 8 out of 10 for creativity, because the ending with Muqtada Muhammad was very poorly. No cutscenes, no dialogue or anything, he just is there and you just kill him for whatever reason. And a 4 out of 10 for controls, because damn, the controls are so bad. Everything together and making a good average, it's about 7.75, which is close to an 8. And in my opinion, that's a perfect number for this game. The controls suck, but everything else is perfect. I'm ending the video by saying, yes, give this game a go. Try it out. Thank you guys for watching. I'll put the cut content after this. Thank you. Bye bye. Oh, and subscribe if you somewhat enjoyed.
Petra was doing great, in charge of his own little army, until the DA indicted his ass on some old corruption charges. In exchange for immunity, Petra agreed to sell out McVigor for enough shit to put him away for 20 years. But McVigor tracked him down. That's where I came in.
Yo, you niggas lost?
Nah, we right here where we want to be.
You sure about that?
Yeah, as long as Petra's here.
What you want with Petra?
What's up? You a cop?
If I was, you'd already know it.
Well, if you ain't, you need to get the fuck out of here, B.
You working for that piece of shit?
Not for, with. Protecting our financial interests.
I was really hoping we could talk this
out. Hope in one hand, shit in the other one. Let's see which one gets full first.
Guess there's nothing else for us to talk about.
Yeah, hey there. Good morning.
Hey, listen. There may be some people coming around here looking for me, okay?
What kind of people?
Government people. In suits.
All right, man. I'll keep my eyes open.
You see anything? You let me know.